Hello students, hope must be fit and healthy. So today I am going to start the second chapter of civics, that is diversity and discrimination. So in the previous chapter we have discussed about diversity, isn't it? So what is diversity? The state of being different from one another is called diversity. Diversity is present in every field of life, isn't it? So, in very, very short, we can say that diversity means different. Clear? Now, in this chapter, diversity and discrimination, you will study some of the terms which will be new for you all, like prejudice, discrimination, stereotypes and equality. Clear? So, how we live, what we speak and what we eat and wear and what we play all depend upon the historical background and the geographical setting of the place we live in. So, students, each of the 8 major world religions is followed in India. There are over 1600 mother tongues, or you can say that 1600 mother language are spoken, and over 100 dance forms. The feeling that we are superior to other people make us narrow-minded. We begin to like only those persons who belong to our religion, who talk in our own language, who follow the same custom as we do. When we meet people who are different from us, we develop a strange and different attitude towards them. We form certain opinion about them. Our views become prejudiced and we start thinking negatively about others by looking their behavior, the way of talking. Isn't it? Negative feeling aati hai dimag mein ki pata nahi ye kaisa bachcha hoga, kaisa insaan hoga. Clear? Now, we can develop prejudice in a negative opinion about many things such as color of the skin, language, caste, religion, region, state and financial position also of the people, whether he is rich or poor, isn't it? Now see, what does prejudice mean? The tendency to judge other people negatively or consider them inferior is said to be prejudiced. Clear? Now we shall take an example here. Now tell me one thing. What is the image of a servant in your mind? They are illiterate, they are careless, they live in an unhygienic condition, they are cunning, they are thieves, isn't it? All these are the negative terms you think negatively, negative opinion towards the servant. But all the servants are not like that. You can see the positive part also, that they are always helpful also, they are caring also, they are loving also, isn't it? So students, sometimes we are so strongly prejudiced that we become rude with certain people. We may even hurt their feelings also. Now, for example, if we speak English or if we think that English is the best language, clear, and other languages are not important, so it is good? No, it is not. All the languages gives their equal importance, have the equal importance. So we are judging these other languages negatively, isn't it? So we might not respect people who speak languages other than English. So this is a prejudice form. Prejudice means to judge other people negatively. If a person doesn't speak English, it doesn't mean that the person is not good. Isn't it? So, we can be prejudiced about many things also, like people's religion, beliefs, as I have already told you about the language, cultures, how the clothes they wear. So, in our mind, everything comes after judging the people. So, there is one more example here you can see on the left hand side of your page. Rural people and urban people. So what is rural? Rural means the village people, and urban means the city or a town people. So what do you think about the rural people or the village people? You used to think that they are illiterate and they are backward looking, isn't it? But it doesn't happen like that. Here there are some of the examples, there are some of the sentences here that more than 50% of all Indians live in villages. Do you agree with this statement? Yes. People in villages do not like to use modern technology. Yes. In peak harvesting and plantation season, families spend 12 to 14 hours working in the field. Yes, sometimes. Villagers are forced to migrate to cities in search of work. Yes, absolutely. Now, there are some statements on the urban people. Life in the city is easy. People here are spoiled and lazy. Do you agree with it? Yes. In cities, families spend very little time with each other. Yes, of course it is. But nowadays, due to the lockdown period, everyone is happy with their own family, because all the family members are together in the house. People in cities only care about money but not people. True, it's very much true. Living in the city is expensive. A large part of people earning is spent on rent and transport. Yes, absolutely true. So these are some of the statements of the rural people and the urban people by which we can differentiate it. We can make an image about it, isn't it? Sometimes it may be negative and sometimes it may be positive also. Clear? So the next topic is creating stereotype. Do you often say villagers are backward looking or they feel that they live a simple life, isn't it? When we form a fixed image or idea of a certain people, we are stereotyping them. For example, if we say that all villagers are illiterate and backward looking, we are having a fixed image on them. Now, one more example to clear it. Most of the Indians think that girls are meant only for housekeeping job. Clear? By forming such an image of all the girls, we are stereotyping them. In fact, such an image of the girls is created by the society around us. If we ask a boy to cook food or dusting, tell him to dust and to do the dusting work, he will feel ashamed to do so. Because in our society, only girls or women are supposed to do it. Clear? Now, is it clear what is stereotype? Stereotype means when one forms a particular image, positive or negative, about something without thinking over it carefully. This is said to be stereotype. It may be with the respect of one's image, one religion, place of origin or residence, sex, race, background, etc. Now, is it clear to you, students? So there is a gender difference between a boy and a girl according to our society which they have created. Clear? Now there is a statement. Now see this. Arrange the statements given below in these two sections according to what you think is appropriate for the section. Now there are some of the sentences given here. Select some of the sentences in the girls group and some in the boys group. Which you think that it is right, that they all are well behaved. Who are well behaved, boys or girls? May I know? It may be girls. Girls are well behaved, isn't it? They are soft spoken and gentle. Who are soft spoken and gentle? Girls. They are physically strong. Who are physically strong? Boys. They are naughty? Boys. They are good at dance and painting, both of them. They don't cry? Boys. They are ruddy? Boys. They are good at sports, both of them, boys and girls. They are good at cooking, boys and girls. They are emotional, girls. So these are some of the statements which create an image that these are the things which boys do and these are the things which the girls do. Clear? So till here, children, have you understood what is the meaning of prejudice? What is the meaning of stereotype? Now student, this is all for today. Thank you. We'll meet in the next video.